Hello everyone, Sebastian here. What you're seeing right now are clips from Panzer announcement trailer. Panzer being my game that just went live. It's an action shoot-em-up with tanks, inspired by the classic Battle City game from the NES console. And this video is first part of post-mortem devlog series that tells the story of its creation. So let's get started. Now I don't know if you heard, but making games can be kinda hard. So first thing I did was I found something that will make it just a little bit, or quite a lot, easier. This is microStudio. It's a game engine, code editor, image editor, animation tool, level builder, well, basically integrated game development environment. Well, almost. Some built-in sound and music synthesizer would be nice to have for truly complete package. Now, I was considering other game engines, Unreal, Godot, Unity and the like. All of them great choices, by the way, but I needed something more focused for the first project. Those big engines add a lot of abstraction to everything, and I want to learn how to make games, not how to use particular tool, but not yet at least. MicroStudio checks a lot of boxes for me. New project starts with nothing but a basic game loop, something that is not accessible at all in big engines. This makes MicroStudio about equal with low-level game frameworks. Most of those, however, use C++, while MicroStudio offers its own language, MicroScript. I don't need performance boost of C++ in this project, and not needing to deal with memory and pointers let me focus on game architecture instead. So this dedicated language is actually a plus. I also think that 2D graphics is a good idea for this project. So everything else is just a bonus. Especially this animation tool and map builder were looking very useful. This put me in a bit of a bind though. While MicroStudio looked great in theory, I never actually used any of its tools or its programming language before, and that meant I needed to learn. Cue training montage. Or I would if I knew how to make one. Thankfully, learning MicroStudio turned out to be fast and easy. It comes bundled with surprising amount of learning materials, from clearly written API documentation to video tutorials showing off most important features to guided interactive tours around the whole environment. Truly great out of 10 onboarding experience. But learning how to use MicroStudio was just one of the reasons I went through all those documentation and tutorials. The other one was to check if this engine will be a good fit for the Panzer project. I already mentioned few of my requirements in this video, code-first approach and building games from the low-level game loop, but I also needed the ability to draw sprites of tanks and do some basic manipulation on them like rotation and scaling. Some way to layer one sprite over another to display damage degree of obstacles will also be required. I knew I will also need animated sprites for explosions, collisions detection to know when the stuff was hit, some way to draw text for user interface and menus, and option to apply sound effects and background music. I learned about most of those features from materials that came included in the engine itself, most because collision detection was a bit more complex. It really doesn't matter right now, I'll get to that at some point. While this list don't look very impressive, this really is all that I needed to make Panzer. And with this realization, I was set on using MicroStudio. But there was one more thing I needed before I could actually start making my game. I scoured opengameart.com in search of assets that will fit my game. Since the centerpiece of the game are tanks, it was really important for me to find some nice tank graphics, and I was really happy when I found 2D battle tanks pack from craftpix.net. They are beautiful and modular, which made composing many different types of tanks a breeze, and they come with a set of special effects too. Another big aspect of the game are maps. They must look good, but most importantly, they need to be clear and give player no trouble in distinguishing the tile type. Here I decided to experiment a bit and went with 140 tiles of Grassland and Mines by Anokolisa. This tileset is designed to be used in platformer or side-scroller games, while Panzer is seen from top-down perspective. It did require more creativity from me while building maps to make sure that tiles fit well, but the amazing art style was worth the extra effort. Last thing I want to shout out is marvelous chiptune music by Juhani Junkala, and I'm so sorry for horribly mispronouncing her name. One of the pieces was used as background to the Panzer trailer, and they add so much to the whole game. The full list of all the assets I used for Panzer is on the screen and, along with the links, in the description below. And with all those assembled, I could finally start making the game. In whole, learning all the required basics of microStudio and searching for assets took me about a week, around an hour or two per day. Let's say 15 hours of groundwork, and while it doesn't look like much, it was significant progress made in just several hours. I had all art and knowledge I'll need just waiting to put it all together. And you can see how it fits all together right now if you like, since the game was made available on microstudio.io. Follow the link in the description to play the game directly in your browser. There's also a link to microstudio project where you can see fully commented finished source code if you want to know exactly how Panzer works right away. In the next part of this devlog series, I'll talk about how I structured my project and about my take on entity component system that is the foundation of everything in Panzer. Last thing, if you especially like Panzer, you can also follow the link to itch.io and buy Panzer's supporter edition to support the game and the channel. Like, subscribe, bell and all that YouTube stuff to get notified when the second part of the Panzer devlog series goes live. Comment below what you think about Panzer, about the video and about my crappy microphone. This was Sebastian and see you in the next video.